The next task was to build the dome support frame, which was essentially a large octagon of doubled 2x8 beams. The main beams are supported by 18-inch boards, so here I'm cutting and assembling the cross beam and supports. I assembled the main crossbeam assembly up on the observing deck, and it's a good thing I did because it ended up being so heavy that it was at the limit of my strength to be able to lift it into place. I put up all the hurricane ties, which is the method used to secure these large beams in place. Here I finally lifted it up to the wall and I'm securing the beams with the hurricane ties. And the same effort had to be done with the other side.
Last weekend, I put up the octagon dome support. And it's basically some really large double 8-inch beams. There was a lot of work to put in. On each end, there's a bunch of supports that support the main cross beam. Then there are two truss hangers on each end of the cross beams, and that's how those go on. And then those are tied together with the diagonals. Each one of the smaller supports, the little 18-inch supports that support the main cross beams, are also hung up with truss hangers. It was a lot of fun to get these measurements right on these diagonals. Had to go back and do some basic geometry, figure out some right triangles. But I finally got them right. The octagon supports a 12-foot circle, which I will put in place this weekend. That'll be the base of the dome.
One of the efforts of the framing that I've been looking forward to doing was to create the first round structures for the dome. Here I am putting together the arcs that form the dome base ring. There were 32 arcs required to make the two full circles. Each layer uses 8 arcs, each of which is 45 degrees. Two circles are laminated with contact cement and screwed together. The first ring I assembled up on the observatory deck, but that was kind of a pain to do. So I built this whole second ring down in the music room. Then I just lifted it up through the gap above the north wall. This clip shows the fun I had in lifting the ring over the north wall. Kind of stressed out the ring, so maybe this wasn't such a good idea to do it downstairs. Building these rings was a great trial run for the work to build the dome itself, which will require similar structures. Once I got the ring up there, I cut out the 16 2x4 lengths that would fit between the two rings. Then I placed the 2x4s in between the rings and screwed them together.
Well, I finished framing out the round dome support. You can see it there from the outside up on top. It was actually a lot of work. Let's go inside and have a look at it. There it is. Round ring. This was made from 32 arcs of plywood that I cut and laminated together, glued it and then with screws. There's a tarp ready to be covered up. Standing on the ladder looking above the observatory, I also added the sloped ribs that will allow the roof to be put on. As with everything else, they're put on with hurricane ties. That goes right to the corner. And then on the inside, I tie them to the supports of the ring with a block of wood and screws. So the observatory is starting to look like an observatory. It's round now. So we have Thanksgiving coming this week. So I will be taking next weekend off. But when we get back, I should be able to put the roof on this thing and then look at covering up the top for a temporary roof to be able to get past inspection. So another great weekend working on the observatory.